Hello, everyone. I'm Chris Erkley. Welcome to your Tuesday edition of Political Empire. Representative Raul Ruiz of Palm Desert was one of 39 House Democrats to vote for a Republican-backed bill to let insurance companies continue to sell policies that don't meet the minimum standards of the Affordable Care Act. Joining us now to discuss it is the reporter Jeff Horseman. Jeff, why did Ruiz vote for this?
Well, he basically said that, you know, he supports Obamacare, but, you know, he thought it was important to provide this as a fix. As many people know, this has been a major issue with the rollout of Obamacare. A number of people with these insurance plans that are not deemed by the Affordable Care Act to meet minimum standards for coverage are seeing them canceled, and there's been a big backlash. And so this is actually, you know, people were, you know, touting this as kind of a test of Democratic leadership. And the fact that 39 House Democrats sided with the House Republican majority certainly can't make President Obama or the House Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi happy.
Jeff, why would Ruiz want to appear to be a moderate?
Well, we've seen this ever since he defeated Republican incumbent Mary Bono last year. He's gone out of his way to try to portray himself as a moderate. He's joined moderate caucuses. You know, he's tried to show they can work with Republicans. I think it really comes down to, if you look at the makeup of his district, Republicans still hold, I believe, a slight lead in terms of voter registration, and he already has a Republican opponent in Brian Estande, the assemblyman out of Palm Desert. And so I think his people feel like he really needs to stress that he is a moderate, particularly after Mary Bono tried to paint him as kind of an anti-American radical, that, you know, that's really going to be key for him for re-election in 2014.
Jeff, what chance does this bill have at actually becoming a law?
No chance, really. Basically, the House passed it. That's controlled by the Republicans. The Senate is controlled by the Democrats. And even if it made it past that, the president would be almost certain to veto it. So it's just one of those things where, you know, you see, you know, gridlock continue to work in Washington and not a lot getting out of either chamber of Congress, particularly on issues like this.
All right. Thanks for joining us. That does it for your Tuesday edition of Political Empire. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time.